I'm Tim Simpson, co-director on the Center for Innovative Material Processing through Direct Digital Deposition, or CIMP-3D. This is a center dedicated to research in additive manufacturing. For those of you that don't know additive manufacturing, you might have heard of 3D printing. Essentially what you're doing is printing up a part layer by layer, one layer at a time until you get a three-dimensional object. The advantage, big advantage of that is that where this sort of part might be made from a subtractive process, where you're removing material from a solid block, here you could actually lightweight structures and print just material exactly where you need it to then create stronger materials that are lighter weight that improve fuel efficiency, fuel economy, and those sorts of things. So this little sample part right here just sort of shows some of the resolution with capabilities, being able to get very fine features and details. With that, holes and geometries that actually go through the part now that previously you couldn't fabricate. There are challenges, though, in terms of how do we actually design these parts now. So as an engineer, being able to support structures, the features and resolution that are on this are forcing us to redesign, and create new CAD tools and optimization methodologies to help us figure out where to place material optimally in that structure.
With additive manufacturing, we have a significantly higher amount of design freedom that we can work with because you don't have to worry about tooling and machining. So this opens up the door to use different optimization tools and methods to minimize the weights of parts while optimizing them for structural properties.
So our specialty in CIMP-3D and additive manufacturing is actually 3D printing metal parts. And so where polymer and plastic parts, we've been able to do that for 10, 15 years now for prototyping, we can actually now produce parts at fine enough quality and resolution and fast enough that they'll be able to use for production. So whether it's hip implants or replacement parts for cars or automobiles, the capabilities now are phenomenal.
We do thermomechanical modeling of additive manufacturing processes. So the biggest challenge, in my opinion, facing additive manufacturing is that during the deposition process, the laser or the electron beam causes large thermal gradients throughout the part. And these thermal gradients cause a buildup of residual stress, which in turn drives distortion. That distortion takes the part out of tolerance and can make it unusable.
We discretize the infinite dimensional vector space with an approximating finite dimensional vector space. And you're probably thinking of the three spatial dimensions as space, but really, our space is temperature. So we find an approximate solution of temperature in this finite dimensional space, and that represents the temperature in every point in a three-dimensional 3D printed part.
So the goal of our project is to evaluate different polymers for use in additive manufacturing. The method we're using is fused deposition modeling. To do this, we're evaluating static and dynamic mechanical properties of our test polymers to those of parts made with polymers and process parameters known to produce well-fused parts. So we're using the RepRap system here. One of the advantages of that is that it's very modular in its use, and also it's open source, so all the designs for all these parts are out there. So say we find something that isn't working quite right, we can take the design, modify it, and so it fits our needs. So one of the main differences between this and the metal system is that we can make parts aren't completely dense. As a metal system, you have to make your part completely dense and not have any empty spaces inside the part. What we can do here is we can define areas where we can have varying densities across the thickness of the part, allowing for different mechanical properties.
We use a couple different materials in these systems. It's fairly common to print ABS or PLA, polylactic acid. These are both thermoplastics. But people are always looking for new materials to print, and so what this project really focuses on is looking at a variety of polycarbonates and polycarbonate ABS blends, turning those blends into filaments for these systems to use, and then trying to see what kind of temperatures are required for the extruder and the bed, and what kind of mechanical properties can be obtained using these materials.